Hey guys, so this time I thought let's do something different. But first, if you are new to my channel, subscribe to my channel to see more of this kind of a DIY. So here I took this already the cutout wood of the pau and then I applied some gesso to cover the surface first before I do anything on top of it. And I did about like two layers there. And then I cover one more time with some white acrylic paint on top. Alright, so before we start anything else, again, if you are new to my channel, subscribe to my channel. If you like to see more of this kind of a DIYs. So for those who are new to my channel, I also have an Etsy shop. Go ahead and check out my Etsy shop. Whatever I do on my YouTube channel, whatever art I make on my YouTube channel, I sell and list those on my Etsy shop. So if you like any of my art, you can always check out my Etsy shop. Alright, so I'm gonna use this alcohol and some alcohol inks too to design the inside part of that area. So I just pour some of the alcohol there. I got that one from a Dollar Tree, and I just kind of pour that, and it seems like the wood wasn't straight, so the alcohol was moving a lot. So I take a little small cap and put it underneath, and I'm just adding this alcohol on all four that little area that's there, and then I'm gonna start adding some alcohol inks on top. And that's the fun part. But I learned one thing is that you don't have to add too much of this alcohol ink. Just stick with the very less, and then let it dry. See if you want to go back, you can always do that. But this is what I learned from this project, that start applying very less of all of the ink first. Alright, and I overfill those area with this alcohol ink. So I also learned that is not to apply too much of alcohol here. Alright, so I started using the yellow first because I wanted to start with the lighter color first, and then as I go I keep adding some darker one. So I really like these two combination a lot, this kind of a peachy pink and the yellow. I'm still not sure about the blue, but because the blue that I have is very dark. So here I am using this green. I really like this green too. I'll show you. So this is the ink that I use to create this kind of a texture. And I'm sorry about my hair that you have to see like that, but I'm just keep adding more and more ink. But like I said, start with the very last thing, otherwise it's just gonna all blend together, and that's not gonna give you that unique texture that you're gonna get with this alcohol ink. Alright, so for the next part, I mean that bigger area, when I pour that alcohol, I try to remember not to add a lot there. Alright, so again I started with the yellow there, and then I just gonna keep applying other colors there. But as you can see right now on those top four area, it's kind of started kind of moving a lot, those inks with the alcohol, and then it's kind of creating the texture that I don't really like. So you'll see me in this video next what I do to fix that. And I'm using a straw right now to kind of blow and move those inks around. Alright, so now I'm just gonna fast forward this part because I don't want you to sit there and watch me doing this part very slowly. So I'm just gonna fast forward this, and you're just gonna see me. I'll just keep adding more and more inks and some more alcohol, and how I fix that four area on top. So just enjoy watching. So the sticker that you can see this below right here, so I put this on my Etsy shop and other places, but whatever I sell on my Etsy shop, whatever profit that I make by selling this sticker, I'm gonna donate 50% of my profit to Black Lives Matter organizations, different organizations. It will be so nice if you can donate and support. I don't know how much I can do, but at least trying to do something is better than nothing. So yeah, if you can support, please support, and thank you for the loves. And all right, so here I already kind of fixed that too, I mean the floor area on top, and I'm kind of adding some more inks on top, but very slowly this time. So what exactly I did is that area was very wet, so I just take a tissue paper and just kind of clean that area with that paper, and then I add some more alcohol, just this time just a little bit, and then add some more ink on top. Alright, so I let it dry for about like a half hour, and then I go back again wherever it bleeds and apply some white acrylic paint. But this inks was these inks are very dark, so I have to do like a 3 layers with the white paint. Alright, so this is the pen that I'm using. I already had that, and now I'm adding some designs there. So I don't know how to explain this part, just keep watching me how I add my designs, and just enjoy. So after I was done drawing everything, it still seems like something is missing. So my ink just ran out, and my ink pen wasn't working. So I have to grab a Sharpie, and then what I did is just go on the edges, and then I also did the edges so that, I don't know, for somehow it looks like everything is now together. It looks pretty. Now it doesn't look empty. This was the last part that I did, and this is how it looks like. So if you guys enjoy watching my video, give a thumbs up and also subscribe to my channel if you are new, and hit that bell button. Whenever I post a new video, you're gonna get a notification. So again, subscribe to my channel. If you have any question, just leave a comment down below, and thank you again for supporting to my YouTube channel and all the loves. Bye, thank you, and I'll see you next time.